Training is the key to keeping ahead of new technology, and a trained employee is a faster, better, happier employee, as we'll see in a moment.
First, though, step into the lab to see how robots are trained. Today's robots can only do so much. They're good at repeating narrowly defined procedures, as long as making judgments or using fine motor skills aren't involved. Stephanie Telex is the director of the Humans to Robots Laboratory at Brown University.
When the environment gets more complicated and less predictable, it's hard to make the robot so that it can be robust to all the things it's going to encounter.
If I want to command the robot to move, I'm going to use my controller here.
That's what PhD candidate David Whitney is working on, using virtual reality to train this robot to pick up smaller and smaller objects.
It could, with enough demonstrations, identify the patterns, identify the colors, the shapes of the cups, and the motions that it made.
With greater dexterity, robots will threaten even more jobs. Until then, one hopes humans and robots continue to play nicely together. Custom Machine in Woburn is a typical manufacturing plant making precision components for industries ranging from semiconductors to aerospace. And like most other manufacturers, the company has been transformed by technology.
This isn't the rosy derivative machine shop. We have more computers than we do employees.
Owner and president Carl Pasciuto has been here for 31 years. Back when he started, they used manual lathes and measured with micrometers. That technology was soon replaced by computer numerical controlled machines that required ever-increasing technical skills.
There were a lot of concerns at that time that you're going to take away work from the machinist working the hand lathe with the micrometer. Well, that didn't happen. The machinists learned how to use the CNC machines. Productivity went up. The machinists earned more. Everybody benefited.
And new technologies helped Custom Machine refine the accuracy of the parts they produced.
We work in millionths of an inch, so the environment here has to be temperature controlled. We work with very high-tech equipment, a lot of automation to achieve these tolerances.
One of the biggest challenges, though, was finding enough people to fill all the jobs.
Computers are not necessarily the salvation for machine trade. We still need skilled labor. We still need people to tell those computers what to do. Even with AI, a lack of skilled labor is a very big problem for this industry.
Do you understand that one? Yeah.
To help find workers, Custom Machine turned its own apprentice program into a vocational school for the machine trade. Companies, even competitors, send employees here to retrain on the latest machining techniques.
So it's a certificate-based learning. So employers will send people here to get the necessary skills in order to be promoted in their workforce. I think people are recognizing it as a trade now that is sustainable, and there's multiple career pathways.
When Chris Nee lost his job in the recession of 2009, he came to the vocational program here to retrain in machining.
I went through their schooling program for 19 weeks, and after that, they actually hired me as an employee full-time. It's basic machining. A lot of the little stuff you learn there, and as you transfer over, you learn more as you're on the job.
Vocational training may be the key to getting a job, especially for workers displaced by technology. Certificate programs that quickly get them launched into new areas and a focus on lifelong learning can help overcome the threat posed by automation, says Joseph Aoun, president of Northeastern University.
We need to launch certificates. And, you know, those are short-term courses that will meet the needs of the learners, will get them into the field.
Aoun says universities have to take the lead and augment their four-year undergraduate programs with basic training in areas like data analytics, cybersecurity, and health informatics.
Ultimately, what education has to do is to make us robot-proof.
And develop workers like these former machinists who can pass on their expertise to future generations.
I tell them when we first started, if you had a USB port, I'd download all the information in your head, but you can't, so get in there and teach it to someone.
You have to measure from here to here.
And everyone agrees, education is key.
It really is about that. As you heard from Northeastern University's president, it's about the certificate programs, it's about continuing education, it's about lifelong learning, it's about constantly being adaptive and also being on the cutting edge of new technology and new learning that will help you keep and maintain your job and maybe move into another job.
Always moving forward. All right, call them workplace matchmakers. They find both quality job candidates and the companies that are hiring.
They have talent, they have knowledge, we have an opportunity, and it works out to be a great fit for us.